Hello everyone. Today I am planning to discuss with you some of the important topics which is exclusively important for both company secretaries as well as for chartered accountant students. In the syllabus specifically we have both Foreign Exchange Management Act and Foreign Contribution Regulation Act. Both collectively put together we will call it Exchange Control Regulations. The first important thing is generally all students will get confused as to which type of transactions the provisions of Foreign Exchange Management Act will get attracted and for which type of transactions the provisions of Foreign Contribution Regulation Act will get attracted. Today in simple terms we will be able to understand for which type of transactions FEMA will apply and for which type of transactions Foreign Contribution Regulation Act will apply. First important thing is we should analyze some important transactions. If you specifically look at any transaction in a company or it might be a person or it might be any partnership, any transaction for that matter in accounting point of view will be divided into two types, commercial transactions and non-commercial transactions. Commercial transactions, as it generally says, that any transaction which is made with the intention to make profit, that would become a commercial transaction. Any transaction which is made without the intention of making profit would be a non-commercial transaction. So this is based on the nature or the characteristic feature of that particular transaction. We can categorize it to commercial transactions and non-commercial transactions. Further, the transactions may be divided into two types based on the area what we have chosen for the purpose of involving in any type of transaction. If we are limiting ourselves within the territory, then we call it domestic transactions. If you are moving outside our domestic territory, then we call it international transactions. So international transactions plays a very important role here. In international transactions, what we will generally see is we can't make payment in our home currency. So we have to convert our home currency into the currency where it is the country where we are trading. So the generally accepted foreign currency, you all know, it will be US dollars. So basically, like, if one country's currency is getting converted into another currency, the legal terminology used is called drawal. So the next important terminology here is that the concept what we are going to discuss is with respect to conversion of foreign currency. As you all know, in domestic transactions, conversion of foreign currency will not be there. Only in case of international transactions, there will be conversion of foreign currency. So now to understand the applicability, that is coming back to the specific topic we are discussing today. For all international commercial transactions, the provisions of Foreign Exchange Management Act will apply. And for all international non-commercial transactions, that is where there is no intention of making profit, where it is charitable purpose or religious purpose, where we are accepting any donations kind of thing, for which the provisions of Foreign Contribution Regulation Act will apply. So that is the basic understanding that we all should know. All commercial transactions, for example, like it might be travel or it might be for investments, all these things are basically commercial transactions. Non-commercial transactions such as donations, all that, all commercial transactions, Foreign Exchange Management Act, that is the general rule, and that should be international. And all non-commercial transactions will be Foreign Contribution Regulation Act. Thank you.